You ever thought about why is the rich rich? Why is the poor poor? Why is the middle class? And why you make the money you make? And what's your value? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Level Up Finance, where we talk about money, mindset, on the road to get millions. And on this episode, let's talk about value and how to increase it. You ever have a friend that constantly asks you for favors? I want you to help them all the time. Want you to put them on to things all the time, but you never could get the same thing in return. You ask for help, no help. You ask for money, they can't help you. They can't put you on nothing, help you with nothing. So you're like, damn, what's this dude value to me? I mean, the friendship is cool, but he always asks me for stuff, but I can never get nothing in return. That person don't bring no real value to you. You bring more value to that person. It's a lopsided friendship. All right. So if you got that type of relationship with somebody, my suggestion, you start bringing the same value they bring you. That's what I start doing. You're never going to feel scammed, bamboozled, or used ever again. I promise you that. So value could be in the form of that, and it could be in other type of value too, like at your job. You get paid, say, $50,000 a year at your job. That's your value to the marketplace. That's not your value with your family, with your friends, and things of that nature. That's your monetary value. If you make $50,000 a year, that's what you're worth. $50,000 a year. But you could increase it. You could increase it by getting more education, job related or not, and then be on a marketplace and get a better job or get promoted at your job. Now you could be making $70,000 a year. You could work harder. You could take on more tasks. You could stay later. You could, take initiative and do things. Increase your value that way. You could go up to $100,000 at your job. I mean, this is one way to increase value, but you got to look at how rich people increase their value. Like Jeff Bezos. Why is he so valuable? I mean, you probably use Amazon every week, all the time. I know I do. It's very convenient to order stuff. They come fast. It's decent quality. So I understand his value. Apple is very valuable. It's in everybody's lives. It's very valuable. You know, Martin Luther King, he got streets named after him. He got schools named after him. He was very valuable. Not because he was a business owner, because he created change. He helped create change in America. That was a big thing. So if you want to be valuable, you got to think and say, what's your skill sets are? What can you do to increase your value? And you could increase your value based on your skill sets. If you a painter, if you could paint, try to get better quality paint, try to push your stuff out there on social media, try to sell it, try to advertise it, try to do something. If you know how to fix stuff, you could do the same thing. Increase your value. You know, the person that helped fix stuff at my house, he's valuable to me because he helps fix stuff, man. I don't have to lift a finger. He will put on a door. He will change the lock. He will put up some walls. And, you know, my electrician is valuable to me because he did do good work. I know I could trust him, show up on time all the time and do quality work. I don't have to worry about getting electrocuted. So he get paid what he get paid. If you show up late every day, if your work is subpar, your value drops. I used to do music videos. I used to do videos, period, and do photography. And I used to get paid where I used to get paid because of my quality of work. I used to be getting called, but that to me was like giving myself a second job. So I fell back and I started thinking about how I can increase my value by doing something else. Or now lately I've been thinking how I can increase my value doing the same thing, but with a more, standoff approach. You know, I already get money through real estate. I'm thinking about how to increase my value with that too. The nicer the apartment, the better quality tenant you get and the more you can charge. If I build a garage in the backyard, the same thing. Better quality tenant I will get, the more I could charge and the longer they will stay. If I got all the amenities in all my places, the tenants would be happy and I'll be happy because I have a long-term tenant that pay max rent that's going to stay longer, you know? So that's a win-win. So you got to think about things like that. My first example of somebody asking for favors all the time, it's cool as long as you bring the same value back. You can't be like, hey, can I get $20? Can you help me, you know, can you pick me up for work? Can you bring me here? Can you do this for me? Can you put me on to this and da-da-da? Unless you're coming with a win-win scenario. And that's how I approach things. I come to people like with a win-win if I'm gonna ask for something. Hey, I do this for you if you do this for me. I scratch your back, you scratch mine. Now, hey, you do something for me. Period, done, over with, end of conversation. No, that's selfish, that's one-sided. you gotta come with one win-win scenarios all the time, especially if that person don't owe you no favors. If that person owe you a whole bunch of favors, then I can understand you, but hey, can you help me out with this? Boom, okay. You already helped them out. You already gave them value. So you're getting that value back in return. But to really get rich or whatever, or really get money, you gotta bring some value to the marketplace. Whatever you may do. I mean, if you cook, bring the best type of food out there. If you cook Jamaica food, bring the best oxtail. Bring the best curry goat. Bring the best, you know, soup out or whatever. You're like, the quality is great, better than the next man's. Your value goes up. Your work of art is look better than the next man's. Your value goes up. Whatever product or service you bring to the marketplace, if it's a better quality than the next man, then your value goes up. You can help out in community and help out your value. You know, you could volunteer. You know, you could donate. You could be a neighborhood watch. You increase your value to your neighborhood, but it's not really monetary, but that's a good thing to do for people, you know, sometimes, like kids especially, to help them out. Because you can steer a kid in the right direction. If you can help that kid not be a gangster, not go to jail, that's priceless. But you brought that kid value if you taught that kid the right way. So all I gotta say is just bring value to the marketplace, man. You know, you might make $50,000, $30,000, $20,000 a day, but as long as you can bring more value to mass amount of people, you could create mass amount of money. Study the millionaires and billionaires or 100,000-a-years, and you can see they bring value. With real estate, with their business or service, even cleaning services, they're doing you a service. They're making you sit back, relax, and they clean your house, or they clean your business, or they clean your car, or they do something for you. That's why they're getting money. If you're not doing nothing, if you're unemployed, you're not doing nothing, you're not really bringing any value. So you can't look at a rich guy and be like, hey, he should pay his fair share. Because the rich guy is creating all these employees. The employees pay taxes. The taxes go to the government. The government cut out them Section 8 checks. The government cut out them welfare checks. The government do the food stamps. Through taxpayers. The government don't generate money. The taxpayers give them the money and the government spends the money. That's how the system works. So, you know, the laws of the land wasn't created by broke people for broke people. It's created for the rich people. So I'd rather be on the rich side than the broke side, because the broke people are going to get screwed over. The rich people will not. We got $1,400. We got $600. We got $1,200 in stimulus. Business owners got millions. That should tell you something alone. Business owners, entrepreneurs got millions because they are the true backbone of America. Without businesses, it wouldn't be no workers. Without workers, it wouldn't be no tax revenue coming through and getting paid to the government. Because as a business owner, I can literally pay no money in taxes. Look at Donald Trump. He pays $700 in taxes. He's a business owner. Mick Romney, when he put out his tax return, when he was running for president, he paid 13% in taxes. Me and you pay like 50% in taxes. So let's be on that side. Let's work on our value. All right? So hopefully you like this one and it made you think a little different. If it does, give me one of these and subscribe. And I'll talk to you on the next one. Level Up Finance.